Member for Nanaimo, North Cowichan.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. The Information Commissioner found that the executive branch of the Premier's office broke the law. She notes that the very person responsible for coordinating access to information for the office is also the Director of Issues Management. And despite being in charge of managing the Freedom of Information process, and despite claims by the Minister and the Premier that training would be provided over years and years, he has received a total of 1 hour of training. That shows you exactly how much respect this Premier has for the public's right to information. Can the Premier explain why the person she assigned to keep a lid on embarrassing information about the Premier is also charged with ensuring the public has legal access to those records?
Madam Premier.
Thank you. Well, the member is wrong, inaccurate, incorrect on a number of counts, in particular that the finding that the Privacy Commissioner has accused people in my office of breaking the law. She simply didn't do that in her report. Having said that, though, her report is one that I certainly welcome. We look forward to being able to make sure that we deliver on the recommendations that she's made. And the way to do that is to make sure that we bring in one of the most respected professionals in this area anywhere in Canada, a former Privacy Commissioner in British Columbia, a former Attorney General. He's going to help make sure that, or Deputy Attorney General, I should say, he's going to make sure that we are consistently applying the Act right across government and make sure that we are also looking forward into the future as new technologies, as the growth in the number of emails continues. We send something like 220 million emails a year just in core government alone. Make sure that we find ways to ensure that the public access to this, public access to information is honoured, that our duty to that in that respect is absolutely met, at the same time that we meet all of the other obligations that are given to us and bestowed upon us by the Act.
Member for Nanaimo, North Cowichan, on a supplemental.
Well, it seems to me that the way the Premier would do it would be to adopt a culture of openness in her own office and set the example, rather than developing a culture of concealment. The issues manager or FOI coordinator for the Premier's office painted a vivid picture of how he goes about collecting FOI records. Once he receives a request, he personally speaks with each individual, 9 separate people within the executive branch, to ask whether or not they have responsive records. He doesn't correspond by email or telephone. He records their answers on post-it notes, then gets rid of the note after dealing with the request. He does not keep any other record. Can the Premier explain why, given her government's massive investment in computer technology, laptops, desktops, iPads, and smartphones, the evolving technology that she boasted about last week and here today, her FOI coordinator conducts important government record searches via post-it notes?
Madam Premier.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Well, in his effort to make political points today, the member ignores the fact that the government has now posts hundreds of thousands of documents that were proactively, without request, and make public on the internet. And we've done that not because we were asked to or required to, not because people even requested the documents, but because we believe that that information should be accessible to the public. That's been part of the commitment that we followed through. In some years, in 2013-14, we fulfilled more Freedom of Information requests than all of the Prairie provinces combined in that same year. We produce 40,000 boxes of information to join the million boxes of information that are being stored on paper that we are preserving securely across government. We are working to make sure that we both protect the public's right to privacy as well as ensure the public's access to information. This is we have a duty to do so under the Act. Mr. Lucadelis will be a welcome, and his advice will certainly be a welcome addition to that, as is the report from the Commissioner herself. We want to make sure that we improve this process, that there's a consistent application across government. The public is depending on us to do that, and that is what we are in the process of doing right now.